Hello, good evening, everybody. Welcome back to the Farini. It's been a couple years since we've been here, so I just want to welcome everybody back. My name is AJ Leese, and I am the new high school theater teacher and auditorium manager. I'm just really, well, thank you. But really excited to serve the community, really excited to get to work with your students. Please stop by, say hello, and please keep coming back. If you got to see the Fantastics, our musical, the musicals are back. We just got the rights on Monday. We're doing a spring play called The Oregon Trail, which is gonna be really fun. So we're going back to State Festival this year and many other concerts, including the middle school one next week. But before I get out of the way, a couple housekeeping things. Phones, if you could take a moment to set those to silent for us. And just as a reminder, no flash photography or recording of any kind for the safety of our performers. The other thing, for masks, for the safety of our performers, courtesy of everyone around you, if for the duration of the concert, if you can keep that up over your mouth and nose, that would be wonderful. Whew. Last thing. It's been really exciting to join this community and watch what Ms. Simcoe and Mr. Fecky have been doing with the students. And you're just gonna get to see that tonight. Tonight is a joyous celebration to welcome us into winter. So without further ado, let's get things started with our harmony group under the direction of Ms. Katie Simcoe. Take care, enjoy everyone.
With a rich history. In 1914, composer Mykola Leontovich was commissioned to write a piece of music based on the traditional Ukrainian folk chant. In 1936, Peter J. Wolkowski adapted the piece with the new English lyrics and a new arrangement for mixed choir. Wolkowski was inspired by the bell-like melody and centered his lyrics around the holiday season. Carol of the Bells has been performed by many notable artists throughout the past century, including Robert Shaw Carell, Bing Crosby, Minium Steamroller, and most recently, the Pentatonics.
Thank you.
Shalom Havarim is a traditional Hebrew folk song that can be sung in unison or in a round. The word shalom has three meanings: hello, goodbye, and peace. And Shalom Havarim is commonly translated as be well, my friends. We are very grateful for Bella Fazio, a member of the concert band who will be playing flute for this performance. Caroline Monahan and Isabel Tanch are featured on percussion. We would also like to recognize our wonderful accompanist, Janice Glasser, a local music director, musician, and private teacher.
Snowy Day is a beloved picture book from 1962 by Jack Ezra Keats. With its vivid contemporary illustrations and text, the book has become one of the most iconic children's books of the last century. It broke the color barrier in mainstream children's book publishing by being embraced across social and ethnic boundaries. Over 60 years later, the book was made into an animated film with music by R&B legends Boyz II Men. The book, the movie, and the song all remind us of the joy and magic that snow can bring, especially in the eyes of a child.
Today is the first. take a moment to say thank you so much for having us. It's been 2 years since we have last performed. So we hope you enjoy the evening tonight. And next up is Jazz Band.
Thank you. Ryan Davison, ladies and gentlemen. That was Herbie Hancock's Cantaloupe Violin. Welcome back. Oh my God, I can't, this has been 2 years. I didn't realize how much I missed it. I really didn't. It's just, you know, everybody deals with the way that they deal with it. And then last week we got on stage for the first time as a whole concert band. And I had a moment. I was like, oh man, I just missed this so much. So we're gonna do something a little bit different right now. We've never done anything like this. First of all, the name of the tune is not Beach. It's another B word that has, but I couldn't put it in the program because it's the holiday season. I can't do that, right? It's a Rolling Stones tune, and it's perfect. But we're gonna feature our very own Max Lockhart. Max. And, in this tune, two things. Number one is the aforementioned kind of cranky title. It's not about a person. It's about love. Love is a beach. Okay, so that's the first thing, and that's actually important. And secondly, Max in this tune is short for maximum. You're gonna get maximum Lockhart right here, okay?
Thank you.
Thanks so much. Thanks so much. Okay.
Hallelu is a traditional Hanukkah song which literally translates to these candles. This song is intended to be sung after the lighting of the menorah, and the lyrics declare that the candles are holy and that their sole purpose is to commemorate the events of Hanukkah. This arrangement includes English text by Becky Slagle-Mayo, and we are thrilled to be accompanied by clarinet by Sam Day, who is a doctoral student at Boston University.
Thank you. have to know anything about Frozen to know the popularity and staying power of one magical little snowman, Olaf. Olaf captured the imaginations of kids and adults alike in two feature-length films, and now the Olaf-themed entertainment just keeps coming. Olaf's Frozen Adventure follows Olaf on his search for holiday traditions for sisters Anna and Elsa. His adventure doesn't exactly go as planned, and in the end, the sisters remind us all that the only holiday tradition we need is to be with the ones we love.
At Juilliard. He has published many modern works for choir and solo piano, and he is one of the most frequently performed composers in the choral world. The Rose was published in 2017 as part of his Winter Songs collection. We are very lucky to have professional string players for this performance. Jennifer Onella and Olga Kuznetsova on violin, Amy Clark on viola, and Anna Seda on cello.
Yeah.
plug the Friends of the Arts. It's thanks to a grant from the Friends of the Arts that we were able to get these wonderful professional musicians. So if we could just give them another round of applause.
Thank you.
Henry Purcell of England, for the third queen of Henry VIII, Mary, Queen of Scots. This was her funeral music after he beheaded her. but just a gorgeous tune. We're going to go into the kind of meat and potatoes of the music. Coming back to do a concert, I just discovered that the repertoire I picked is just, it's all like kind of comfort food. Because if you just haven't done this in so long. So here's a beautiful piece. I'd like to feature Ryan Dennison again. This is the band. The band is going to play their version of Beethoven's 8th piano sonata, the second movement called Pathétique. And the best compliment I can give a band is not conductors. And I mean that. They don't need me. That's what we're looking for here. We're looking for self-sustainability. So it's them, by themselves, playing this.
Thank you.
it was the finale for Beethoven's Fifth. And we'd like to close this concert out with a traditional number that we always play. But before I do, I'd like to echo Ms. Simcoe's sentiments. Thank you to the Friends of the Art, and a special thank you to Mr. A.J. Leese, the brand new theater teacher, who's his first concert. He's doing a great job. We'd like to finish this out playing Leroy Anderson's Sleigh Ride. Cambridge, Massachusetts' own Leroy Anderson. I'm going to invite a young lady, Ava Campman, up to conduct. She's going to hopefully get to the University of Vermont and major in music education, which is incredibly flattering. Ladies and gentlemen, Ava Campman.